I'm happy to kick off this Ory Summit 21. My name is Thomas Curran, joined here with Aeneas Rekkas, also known to some of you as Hackerman. We put together this Ory Summit mostly for the people out there that are in our community. We know that there are plenty of interesting examples of companies using Ory, and it's only regretful for us that we don't have time to talk about all of them, but we did our best, and special thanks goes out to the team at Ory behind putting this session together.
Thank you, Thomas. Thank you very much for the introduction. So my name is Aeneas, and as Thomas already said, you might know me from Slack or GitHub as Hackerman, and I am really truly excited and honored to have you all here. So this stage really belongs to you, the community, and it is awesome to see so many talks and sessions today. A year of moonshots at Ory, and you know, don't worry, we're not pivoting and becoming the next SpaceX. We're not physically going to the moon, but bringing what was once a hobby project that was started in university and then got into my living room, my shared flat, is now a real company that's going from zero to one, can sometimes feel as challenging. And in this talk, I want to take a step back with you and take a look at what happened in the last year at Ory, and also what's going to happen at Ory in the next year, 2 years, 3 years, and so on. It's quite strange that, you know, we use the internet every day, but it's still a little bit weird to interact with it, having like all of these passwords and profiles and everything. But also the development process is broken. So when I started building a new online platform in 2015, I was told that, you know, authentication is a solved problem. But I quickly realized that it's actually incredibly hard to implement secure login, registration, account recovery, multi-factor authentication. And for some reason, this concept that complexity means security is, you know, prevalent in the community. And I think that's not true. Like, security should be simple, because then it's very easy to get right and it's hard to get wrong. And this is why we released on January 1st, 2020, the first version of Ory Kratos. And the goal of Ory Kratos is to make really hard things really simple to get right. So the vision for Ory Kratos is to become as ubiquitous as SQL or as DNS. In a few years, the question will not be, you know, how do I add login or identities to my app? It will be, okay, which version of the like Ory identity specification do I use? And today I'm very excited to announce the Ory Kratos version 0.8, so the eighth iteration, which is available as of now. So first of all, we have full support for multi-factor authentication. First of all, that means that you can use TOTP, which is Google Authenticator, so using your phone, as a second step in login verification. We have also WebAuth and FIDO2 and U2F. That means YubiKey, hardware tokens, biometric tokens, other forms of tokens that prove that you are in possession of something that proves that you are who you are. And of course, we have recovery codes, which means that if you lose your device, if you lose your YubiKey, if you lose your phone, then it still works, because you have a recovery code, which you can print out, write down, and get access to your account again. We also added flexible multi-factor session policies, which means that, you know, sometimes people want to log in and they want to access a part of the system, and you don't necessarily need high security for that purpose, like, for example, accessing a feed or something. But you might for other tasks, like taking an order. Here, you can use what we call soft MFA policies. Or if you need really tight lockdown, you can use hard MFA policies with Ory Kratos. You can find more about this in the Ory Kratos documentation. And also, we're publishing some examples for that. Besides that, we have made massive improvements to the SDKs. Those are still auto-generated and rely on the OpenAPI spec, and it's sometimes really difficult to get all the generators for all the different specs to just work right with your programming language. But given your extensive feedback. We have learned where the challenges are. We have learned what we can improve and how to adapt to the open API spec so that these systems work for Ory and for you. So we have made some big, big changes. Also, SVOM, which means software supply chain scanning and reporting, are now available. We are a very security conscious company, and that also means that we need to secure the software supply chain, which we have seen in the past year can be very vulnerable. Apart from that, we also have XChacha 20, 40, 13, 05, or alternatively AS, GSM encryption for sensitive database columns. This too was a community contribution, and thank you again. Besides that, we also now support ARM builds, meaning that our software runs on M1 Max, and this also applies to our Docker images. And last but not least, we also now have finally advanced email templating support, meaning that you can generate emails, for example, during account recovery or verification, that allow you to add, you know, more context into the email. And also it's possible to translations of those emails. We have really, you know, so much more planned. We have in store passwordless auth, meaning that you can use FIDO 2 keys, so hardware tokens, for example, to sign in and sign up, or use fingerprint, face ID to sign in or sign up. No more needing, you know, to have a password. This is, I think, one of the major, major topics that we'll address in Ory Cloud in the next versions. We also want to support decentralized identity standards, which are being developed by MIT and others around the world, making it easier, making it possible to reverse the direction of the data flow from users to large-scale providers, turn that around from large-scale providers to users. We have made such large changes to the features and the richness of the system, but yet we did not have almost any breaking changes in the APIs. This means for us and for me that Ory Cloud is finally becoming mature. That means that we will release Ory Cloud version 1.0 next year. Ory Cloud is also another moonshot. And originally, Ory Cloud was taken out of the original Ory Hydra, and it has gone through several iterations. It was really a learning curve that, you know, authorization is really, really difficult to get right, because what works for use case A really well, maybe not work for use case B at all, or for use case C, it might take 10 seconds, 15 seconds to reach an answer. That is why we decided to implement Google Sensibar. And to give you a little bit of context, Google Sensibar is the system which powers YouTube, Google Cloud, Google Search, Google Workspace, basically all of Google's operations. And every time Google has to ask, hey, is this user allowed to do that? Google Sensibar offers an answer in below 10 milliseconds of response time. So we've decided to implement the first ever open source implementation of the Google Sensibar paper. And we've published that as Ory Cloud version 0.7 7 months ago. It's a major rewrite. And Ory Cloud really is the first ever open source project to pull this off. We also want to actively work to make common things such as role-based access control, which is very normal, easy to work with on top of Ory Cloud. Because even Google Sensibar, with its extensive policy language and it's easy to adopt and easy to change, it's still sometimes a little bit challenging to just use user role permission. So we want to make that easy as well. And on this occasion, I want to say thank you, A, to everyone who participated, B, to all the speakers and all the presenters who worked tirelessly on the presentations, and of course, to the Ory team who has been holding the Ory Summit fire drills for the past week or so, which you also again hear my voice. And last but not least, to Marnie, Thomas, Tobias, and Vincent, who have made possible this event in the first place. So thank you. Seeing all of these events, I can say that Ory is maturing. And, you know, what started as a hobby project in the quarters of the university I attended, and then in the living room, and then in some shared co-working space, it has become a community, and it has become a movement with a heart and a soul and a fire. And, you know, Ory has become a real company with almost 20 employees. And you might have noticed that we are pushing out more patches, more products. There's more website updates, and we become even faster and better. And our vision is to make the digital realm more secure. It's a little bit like Stripe for payments, but it's open source and even more ambitious. With that, I'm extremely happy to announce publicly for the first time ever on the summit that we've raised $25.5 million in the past year as funding. That is split into $3.5 million seed round led by Bellaton Capital and InQtel, and $22 million Series A round led by Insight Partners, along with Bellaton Capital. We have raised this money because we want to build a thriving, lasting, open and sustainable company and provide you with the best tools in class. You know, running open source, I can say for myself, can be fun until you know things stop working and you need to focus on other tasks and things scale and you're trying to rush deadlines. Today, we're announcing Ory Cloud, the best place to run Ory. And Ory Cloud, it's currently in private beta, seamlessly interacts with the open source stack. You will be able to run Ory projects like Ory Kratos or Ory Hydra yourself without having to rely on Docker, Kubernetes, and so on. It's still, of course, possible to run Ory on your Raspberry Pi, on some ARM, and your fridge if you want to hack your fridge, or your Game Boy. I think some community members are doing that. And of course, Kubernetes and Helm and Docker and everything. But if you just need things to work reliably at scale, you need things to be resilient and fast, have SLAs and low latency, then Ory and Ory Cloud is the best place to be. And with Ory Kratos, you will be able to use the CLI, as you can see on the slide on the right side. So for example, to create a new Ory Kratos deployment, you'll just do Kratos create deployment, and that's it. And then you can set a config, for example, using Kratos config set, or you can import the config that you've tried out locally in Docker with Kratos config import. Kratos tunnel ensures that cookies and other security mechanisms work flawlessly as well. Not only that, but we're also working actively to getting Ory Hydra to version 2.0. Here too, the easiest way to Ory Hydra to run Ory Hydra is and will be in Ory Cloud. But not only that, Ory Hydra has also some exciting new features in the pipeline. So one of them will be hardware security module. So what that means is you have a dedicated piece of hardware in your data center, which can provide cryptographic keys to sign and encrypt, for example, JSON Web Tokens, or encrypt data in your database. The database model we have today, it works really well and it scales, but there are sometimes issues and we've heard your feedback. So we're working actively to improve the state of the art of Ory Hybrid. Finally, there are more OAuth 2 specifications being implemented, such as OAuth 2 token exchange or OAuth 2 token impersonation. And while I said that OAuth 2 is complex, and OpenID Connect is complex, and they're not the best solutions for login, they are definitely imperative protocols to use when you need, for example, machine-to-machine authentication or delegation flows or other types of flows. If you're excited for these new developments, become an Ory Insider. Ory Insiders get privileged access to Ory Cloud Beta and have a dedicated link to the developer team. So for example, Patrick or even myself or the other developers in the team. And you get to exchange ideas and problems and ask for help. To become an Ory Insider, just go to the website, click on sign up, create a project, and request to become an Ory Insider. As an attendee of this conference, you will get a month for free. You've also contributed, I think, tens of thousands of lines of code just in the last year, and that's just mind-blowing. We feel overwhelmed by the positivity and expertise you have brought to light. And as a community, you have downloaded, as Thomas already said, around 40 million of times stuff from Docker, from Ory. You have left almost 30,000 GitHub stars, and there's like almost 30,000 deployments running Ory software in production, which is, again, mind-blowing. We also know what we need to work on. So we want to get better at answering your questions on Slack. We want to review and merge pull requests much faster than we're doing today. And we want to be able to answer your questions more timely and give you more help and better help to make you succeed with the Ory stack. Lastly, we want to write better documentation and make it easier to understand how Ory works and give you more examples, better examples, and easier to use get started guides. We all here at Ory are truly humbled, and thank you so much for being here. on this journey, which started on October the 26th, 2014, with the Git hash 69E95AB. And with this, I want to give back to Thomas. I hope you will enjoy the talk. Thank you for listening.